Excuse me, Mayor?
What? Mayor? Why did you say that?
Sorry, I was thinking of a different mayor.
But alas, I am merely Maiden's Feast Marshal Dune, a humble man of the people, for now.
What does that mean?
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
Can I have it?
Certainly not. It's an integral part of my soon-to-be mayor look.
So, you're running for mayor of Shellmound?
My hopes and dreams. Just sandcastles built too close to an angry sea. I had hopes, child. But this construction debacle under my marshalship has washed them all away.
This world is crazy.
When is Mount Chakra supposed to get here?
Any minute! So much to do!
Oh no.
I need to enter the Maiden's Feast.
Child, at this point, we may not even have a Maiden's Feast. Not that you have the right scent for it anyway.
Are you saying I smell bad?
Oh, heavens no, child. You smell like birthday cake and fluffy clouds. With a hint of fresh pine. But that's just not the sort of aroma that hooks the big fish. Talk to your grandmother. I'm sure she has a fragrance recipe she'll share with you.
Whoa, what was that? The screen just shook.
Did you say there might not be a Maiden's Feast?
The sea, she is angry this day. I'm trying to build the offering arena, but the waves keep washing it away.
Why do you build the offering arena so close to the ocean?
Because that's where the sand is.
Oh my gosh.
There has to be a Maiden's Feast. I need to kill Mog Chothra.
Yes, yes, we all want to fill Mog Chothra. But when he comes here and sees no offering arena, he might pass us by. Or worse.
Better let you get back to the feast.
Yes, yes. These maidens aren't going to serve up themselves.
No, no, not like that. Okay, ooh. She does it.
These fishing poles are useless. All the hooks have been stolen.
That's good.
Oh, boy.
Looking at this chum trough makes me really happy I grew up in a baking town instead of a fishing town. I just hope my baking town is still standing.
Oh, wait. These are the maidens, huh?
Hi. You maidens getting ready for the Maiden's Feast? Nice costumes.
Thanks. Our dads made them.
They're the best fishermen in the village, so they're pretty good at tying lures.
We had to use every hook in town, but it was worth it.
Isn't somebody gonna miss those hooks?
Not as much as they're gonna miss us.
You're gonna make me cry, girl.
The maiden's nervous.
Yeah, nervous that Marshal Dune isn't gonna get the offering arena ready before Mog Chothra gets here.
Oh, I can't believe our dad's donated so much to his campaign.
You have a familiar voice, too.
I want to be in the Maiden's Feast.
Of course you do, poor thing.
But Shell Maidens are chosen only after a long period of qualifying events.
Also, our dads are pretty powerful. Also, can I tell you something? Just as a friend.
Oh my god, yes, just as a friend.
You just don't smell right, girl.
Oh, I'd want a friend to tell me that.
Hey, can I have some of that perfume?
That's not perfume. That's a proprietary luring compound known as Beast Hooker.
It's irresistible to moths.
Don't you guys ever wonder if there's another way? To save the town, I mean.
This is how it's always been done.
Yeah, they figured out how to do it a long time ago, so we wouldn't have to think about it.
Wow.
Hey, can I have some of your Beast Hooker?
That's better. But no, you can't. Sorry.
It's her secret sauce.
It's my grandmother's traditional cocktail of musk, pheromones, and animal sweat. And I'm not sharing it with anybody.
Well, I don't need it anyway. Daddy says I exude it naturally.
Wow, okay.
See you maidens later.
Ciao!
Those shell maidens won't share their monster bait with me.
Please, that's terrible.
I know. They won't give me a single drop.
No, I mean it's terrible what a tattletale you are. No perfume will cover up poor sportsmanship, young lady.
Oh my.
A sighted stranger approaches. I sense it as well. Not so fast. Darn, all out of holy tear gas.
Use the staff.
Oh, yeah. Halt! For the Deadeye God sees no one.
Who are you two?
I am Deadeye Dawn, and this is Deadeye Courtney. Hi.
What is this place?
The Deadeye Pyramid. Tomb of the Deadeye God. As if you didn't know.
Who's the Deadeye God?
The Messiah from the sky. Bringer of miracle objects. Someday he will rise to return our sight and begin the Battle of Volgentol.
Huh.
Did your god bring any miracle objects that were, like, weapons? The kind that could take down a giant monster before it destroyed your home village?
Good question.
Our god had such power and more! Probably. I mean, really, we don't even know what half the stuff in there does.
Can I go inside?
You wish to invade our holiest of shrines? Why?
Because you guys are guarding it. So it must be cool.
Oh, it is. Extremely cool. But no one enters the Deadeye Pyramid. No one. Well, unless...
What?
Well, if she could solve the riddle of Yorn... Oh, yeah. If she could solve that, then she'd definitely be worthy.
No problem.
Okay.
Could you remind me how the Riddle of Yorn goes one more time?
You always take us down when we are in our prime. Devour your sweet rewards, yet I'll return in time. A child of mine will rise out of his rotten bed, up from a hidden pit, long after I am dead.
Whoa.
Yeah. Bring us the solution, and you may enter the pyramid.
Did you say you lost your sight?
Yes, that happens when you blind yourself.
Oh.
If the Deadeye God has no need for sight, then neither do we.
Huh.
Huh, yeah.
Hey, can I get you guys something?
Like what?
I don't know, cheeseburger? Oh, there we go.
Maybe a refreshing beverage?
No, thanks. I've got a flask of barnacle juice under this robe. Diet barnacle juice over here.
Yeah, gotta watch that weight. How about...
Hey, can I get you guys something?
Like what?
Something to read?
We're blind.
Have you not heard of Braille? Maybe they don't have Braille in this world. This one?
Check it out. Fruit.
No thanks. These are our only robes. We don't want to get them all sticky.
It's the answer to your riddle.
But it's just a fruit. With a pit inside.
Oh my god.
It's so simple. Why didn't we get that?
Oh man. That's been bugging us all day.
But what does it have to do with the pyramid?
Huh? Oh, nothing. It's just something our friend Becky Yorn told us this morning. She thinks she's so smart. I can't wait to rub this thing in her face.
So, can I go in there now?
Oh, yeah, whatever. Knock yourself out.
Well, okay.
I'm going in.
Okay.
I'm going in. Try stopping me. We won't.
Such strange shapes in here. I wonder what that symbol means. The top of this pyramid is transparent. So strange. It's that same religious symbol, but this one is recessed, like a socket. There's that symbol again. Guess this is where they buried their old god.
Wow.
I don't think that will fit in this socket.
It is the same shape as this.
I don't think that's the right shape to go in there. That symbol is so strange, but familiar. I think climbing up on their god's guess this is where they buried their old god. Wait, is this east? West?
Oh, there's the
snake. Let go! Can't breathe. Oh boy. This is tight. I thought that corset was bad. Can't breathe. I think this woman, case of snake, don't want to die this way. Okay, so do not go that way. Got it. Hi.
Hey, Vella.
Hey, about this art.
Yeah?
Can I have it?
No way, man. That thing's vintage.
Aren't you bothered by your Sylvius themes?
I probably would be, if I had such a superficial understanding of the work.
How do you know it's hanging right side up?
Because the dude's little feet go on the bottom, duh.
Where'd you get it?
I bought it from this slightly shady girl from Shellmound. Said she was selling it to get money to move out of town.
What is it?
Well, you know. It's abstract. It's kind of a tone poem, really. I find it does some interesting things with the space between viewer and image.
Okay. I like how it matches your decor.
Decor? I don't have a decor. The purpose of art is not decor, man.
Why do you have it up then?
I only had it up there ironically, but I was actually getting sick of it. If you like it, just take it.
Really? Okay.
You just said I couldn't have it.
Catch you later, Curtis.
Beware the trees.
What the heck? These people are full of semantics and confusion.
Check it out. Non-talking wood.
Oh, and it's so smooth. Oh, man. I feel a stool coming on.
What?
Phrasing?
Ooh. That's a relief.
Phrasing?
I feel 10 times better. Thanks for helping me get that out of my system.
Hey,
really?
Phrase it!
Thanks.
No problem. I like to spread my samples around.
Phrasing.
Wow.
Okay, I'm taking this.
Cool. I liked that kind of stuff when I was your age, too.
All right, I'll be on my way.
Shh! Here she comes again!
I'm going in.
Okay.
All right, so I got this little thing. Should go in there. Oh, it even is the shape of it. So that works. Oh.
Man, my mouth tastes like death. Oh, hey. You found my circuit control router. That's awesome. Now I can fire up the ship and get back to Laruna.
You... Are you that kid?
Are you the Deadeye God?
Man, that's so embarrassing. The locals called me that when my spaceship crashed here, and I kind of went along with it because, well, you know, God.
You're welcome.
Oh, yeah, thanks for finding my circuit control router. I lost it during the crash and couldn't find it anywhere. I drew pictures of it for the locals and kept saying, "Give me this, give me this." After a few years, I just had to put myself in cryogenic storage and hope someone smarter would come along and find it.
Were you really dead?
Nah, I was just preserved in cryogenic suspension for 300 years? I guess all the locals I knew here are long dead. That's kind of a relief. They were a little annoying. Part of the reason I went into chrysolation, to tell you the truth.
So, the kid... Is it the same kid, I wonder? So that kid is from the past. Oh, how crazy. Or is this girl from the future?
So we're standing in a spaceship?
Just the upper observation deck. The rest of it's buried underneath. I'm gonna need to fix more wiring before I can even gain access to it.
Does the ship you mentioned have any weapons?
Hey, whoa.
There's a giant monster that is destroying villages and eating young girls, and it may or may not have already... My whole family might be... Anyway, I just need to take down a horrible monster. Will you help?
I mean, sure. I owe you one. But my ship didn't have any weapons that I know of. I'll dig around once I get this heap working and let you know.
Huh.
What's Laruna?
That's my home planet. Or at least it was. Who knows if it's even still there.
What's all this equipment do?
This is the main observation deck of my ship. So this stuff mostly scans for signs of life or habitable worlds. Anything that would help the mission.
Can I help?
Depends. You know anything about spaceships?
No. I'm just a baker from Sugar Bunting.
Sugar Bunting? Is that anything like Steel Bunting? When I first landed, there was this town called Steel Bunting that the locals were all afraid of. Apparently, it's full of badasses.
Hey, that might have been the one that Grandpa was talking about, the Village of Warriors. What exactly was your mission?
What was your mission?
Operation Dandelion. Laruna was dying.
You are the kid!
The spaceship was supposed to give us a fresh chance and a new home. But instead, we crashed here.
How'd your ship crash?
I hate to think about it, but there's a chance it was me. I tried to hack into the ship's controls and take over. Then some weird stuff happened, and the next thing I know, I'm here.
Okay, see you later.
Uh-huh.
Ooh, pretty colors. Whoops!
Oh.
Hey, that was my amplifying quartz. Without that, how am I supposed to read the data from the search beam?
Sorry, I'll get a new one.
So clutch.
Don't bother. All I really care about is getting out of here, and I don't need a search beam for that. Hey, put that laser coil back. That's how I generate light for my search beam.
I'm just cleaning it.
Wow. This probably goes there.
There. Good as new.
Actually, that's not bad. And you even got it in the right slot.
Cool.
The top socket is empty.
Yeah, because you stole my laser coil. You better put it back.
Oh, my goodness.
There. It's back. Safe and sound.
I hope you put it in the right socket. Otherwise, the scanning beam could overheat.
Oh, okay, so you present...
Sorry to do this to you, but...
Oh my god, is that mutilated tree flesh?
You see, what Curtis does is he peels off the outer layer of the wood to get to the tender stuff inside. Then he dips the whole thing in an acid bath before he begins the deep carving. Oh. Sorry, did that upset you?
You monster!
Wow, it's getting thicker every second.
Strong stuff, kid. Don't mess with it.
Wow, phrasing.
Hey, what are you doing?
I found a replacement for your quartz thing.
Maybe, but you put it in the wrong socket. You get that order wrong and you'll melt us down into a sad little puddle.
Interesting. Here's me messing things up.
Nailed it!
What have you done?
Fixed your ship?
You put the amplifying quartz after the laser coil. If I powered up the beam in this configuration, I mean, the thermal feedback alone could melt down my entire ship. I could conceivably release the extra energy out of the targeting iris, but that would only produce a powerful weaponized... Well, heck, let's just call a death ray.
Yay!
Okay, I guess it worked. So putting it in correctly doesn't do anything.
You're so ugly. I'm glad I'm blind.
Okay, the targeting iris has 300 years of rust on it, but it should do the trick.
I'll try to lure him into a good spot.
You can fire the weapon with this remote trigger.
Like this?
Oh, bird.
Okay, shut it down.
Clarence, was that you? Knock it off!
Just use quick bursts or that hacked circuit of yours will cause a meltdown up here.
I'm not sure how to thank you for this.
You know what? The whole time I was on that spaceship, all I really wanted was to be as useful as I feel right now.
Well, wish me luck.
Hey, if you're really from Steel Bunting, I'm sure you're not gonna need it.
Well, I guess I do have a weapon for him. Now I just need to do the contest. Probably see what I can do at the clouds. Maybe I can tell that other maiden, hey, I have a way now. A big, powerful weapon. Oh. The guy's gone.
Hello? Is it there?
Hi.
Is anyone down there?
Hi there.
Is it there? You need to tie some ladders together. Did you hear me? Is it there? You getting the ladders?
Oh, it must be the guru. You don't want to give her the ladder back?
Want your ladder back?
Nah, keep it. I'm gonna use it later as an excuse for not dusting the upper nests.
Hard.
Oh.
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
It looks great on you. Very fancy.
What? Fancy? But I'm a man of the people.
Really?
I'm never going to win this election if I come off as haughty and elite. Here, take this away from me. Thank you, child.
Seriously?
Firing my stylist tomorrow.
Better let you get back to the feast.
Yes, yes. These maidens aren't going to serve up themselves.
this whole time.
It's already soaking into the ground. I have to catch it when it's fresh. It's already soaking into the ground. I have to catch it when it's fresh.
Oh.
Oh, and now you're decorating me like a Christmas tree? Is there no end to the humiliation?
Is there no end to your complaints?
You can still see the grain of the wood. Wow, the sap is super thick.
All right. We're so mean to trees.
Wait for the tide. Can you hear me?
Wow, the sap is super thick. I don't think that would help the arena get built.
Yeah, it would. Mix the sand with the sap.
Here, this will make your sand mixture stick together better.
Really? How do you know?
I'm a baker. I know my ingredients.
At this point, I'd try anything. Hey, Clarence! Bring that load down here, will you? I hope you're right about this.
It's never failed me before.
How many times have you used it?
Never. Shh. Let's watch.
Here comes a wave. I can't look.
What'd I tell you?
Now that's a sandcastle. Looks like we're in business. All we need to do now is get those maidens in tune.
All right. Still have the bucket? No. I was kind of hoping to use it.
All right, girls, time for the talent portion.
Sup, maidens?
I thought I had something, but
Marshall Dune?
Hmm.
I need to enter the maiden's feast.
Well, I suppose I do owe you one for your help with construction. Unfortunately, you just don't have the right scent for it, my child.
Better let you get back to the feast.
Yes, yes. These maidens aren't going to serve up themselves.
I just need to be stinky, I guess.
But how could we both have had the same exact ring?
What's the Battle of Vulgantol?
The final battle between humans and mugs. The end of our entire age.
Sounds promising. What is that strange symbol I see all over the pyramid?
You mean the Gamethus? That was the sacred symbol of the Deadeye God. It is said that in his day, the Deadeye God would draw the Gamethus for all his followers. It was very important to him, and so we worship it to this day.
He was simply trying to get everyone to find the device that he needed. That was funny.
Hey, did you guys see the Deadeye God?
She must have heard us talking. Look, it was only a shared vision. Perfectly normal among devoted people, especially when they've been standing up all day. The blood goes to your feet.
Hey, okay. Hey, can I get you guys something?
Like what?
Some more holy tear gas?
Oh yeah, here. Just fill that up for me if you could. Thanks.
Bye.
Sense you later.
That's really all I needed, huh? I'm guessing I can put some of this into this.
Oh, Mark, shine your light on me.
Come to me, old chum. I mean, when is this not going to come in handy? Mm-hmm.
Gross, Drusilla! Don't you think I can smell that? Okay, this time it really wasn't me.
What? Evil.
Hey, maybe this perfume is what's attracting them. I'll get rid of it.
Great! Ow! Great idea!
What about me?
Ow! I exude it naturally! She has to save whom she can't. Ow! I'll tell Mog Chothra about you, Drusilla.
Alrighty.
Who did it?
Get this nasty shit out of here.